Hello and welcome everybody back to another episode of Road to Eagle Stars. Today we are playing Melting Magma Melee, one of, if not the most notable staff ghost in all of CDGP. Not the hardest staff ghost. Some people say it's the hardest, some people think it's the hardest. In my opinion, it's not. We definitely have some harder ones that I've still yet to beat that will be in the near future, but this one of course is always going to be a challenge. Very difficult track. It's a Russo X staff ghost, which means it's going to have at least some sort of difficulty to it. But we are going to give it our best shot. We are going to get these 250 gold stars, and even no matter what's in our way, we are going to try our best to take it down. So the staff ghost course by Russo X, a 254.466, and the world record BKT is by, of course, Russo X again, with a 247.702. This is one of the tracks that Russo X time traveled the most. As you see, a pretty big gap between the staff ghost and the world record. This is definitely, I can definitely take the staff ghost down within less than some other ones, in my opinion. Alright, so this track is just really, really tech heavy, really difficult. There's a lot of things to take in. So first off, he wheelies off this first ramp here. Gets a trick to the right. Hop trick again. Doesn't do the other strat. I might do the other strat off that little thing, the statue. Mini turbo, another mini turbo. One, two, three tricks. I'm gonna go for two. And then another trick here, this I'll do as well. Hop trick, and then trick out there. This shortcut. Yeah, he takes that really well. Obviously, I know how to do it. Just TS strat, shroom, spin drift, and trick. Here, just keeps a straight line. Gets a bunch of tricks. This next shortcut I'm going to do, staff ghost doesn't do it, but it saves a buttload of time, and it can definitely help me beat the staff ghost if I do it. Just like that. Toast factory strat again. Get some mini turbo. Trick. One trick off of that. Obviously it'll be different for me. With different at different paces. But he gets really strat off that thing again. I can do that all. I can do all of that. This loop skip as well. He really is here. I might not do that. I'll see honestly how it is. I just don't want to fall off there. That'd be really risky. Really unfortunate as well if I fall off in that section. But this loop skip, I'm gonna have to do really fast as well, because I can definitely save a lot of time when the staff ghost if I do it quickly. So like he slows down a little bit and spin drifts so you can just get the stick and takes it nice and tight. So that'll take a little bit of practice, but I can definitely get it down. And yeah, he just repeats it. Just does the snow cut again, one more lap. And yeah, we are gonna do race the staff ghost and see how this goes. Okay, now, it's honestly crazy how I started like playing custom tracks like a year ago, and I decided, you know what, like 10 months ago, I'm like, okay, in order to get really good at these custom tracks, I'm going to get all the gold stars. I'm going to be every single staff ghost in the game. No matter how long it takes me, no matter how hard it is, I'm going to try my best and get all of them. And here we are 10 months later, and we have eight left, as of obviously I've uploaded that much, but just eight. But some of these eights are the hardest ones in all of CGP. It's like the final bosses, if you can say that. So even though we're this close, we are almost still really far away to getting our final goal of 250. And did I make that first try? Wow, okay, cool. See, we're winning right now. This is cool, wow. See what I mean? Like, what if I beat this right now? It'd be funny. I will laugh a lot. Like, this went from just me talking to, like, me focusing. I made that first try. See what I mean? I'm actually, like, already pretty decent in this track. Like, I already knew what to do. Oh, God. That was so bad. Caught me a lot there. Got the stick, but I lost a lot of time. See what I mean? That loose skip, I don't know how to do it very well. So it took a lot of practice. But we're not that far behind at all. That was no wheelie as well, unfortunately. This is probably what I'm going to do, just like this, and then that. Some bats. Does he shroom lap 2 or lap 1? Looks like he does it lap 2, unfortunately. That sucks. Okay. That doesn't gain nearly as much time as the other thing, though, so that's good. Let's do this. Spin drift and trick. Easy. Dude, he's actually right there. He's like right there, man. This is not even like... This is first try. This is first try. What the heck? Okay, now I have to go straight down here. Oh no! Aw, dude. That'd be cool if I at least got a run first try. Like, that was literally, I'm not kidding, that was first attempt. That's why I started talking about my journey to getting all these gold stars. And then all of a sudden I just got that shortcut first try and I got a run going. This is totally new. I didn't even do the trick off this thing. Because I was like focusing on what I was gonna say. This thing. A lot of focus to, oh god, I didn't get a trick off that. Wow, okay, that was weird. I guess you have to be more to the right, because that one you can trick a lot earlier than the second one. The second one you have to wait a lot longer. It's all just about memorizing the timing and knowing where to go and knowing where to trick. But once you know that, it's super easy. It's actually pretty helpful to gain a little bit of time and break away in online races, of course. Nice. Nice. Just trick here, die. Obviously in this section you want to just hold a straight line throughout these fireballs. And you don't want to just move left or right at all, especially here, because if you do, you are going to get sent flying across the thing like I am right now. See what I mean? I was moving too much. I might not even stand my wheelie there. I might, depends, because like, I'm just moving all over the place. Like, it's just really weird. If you touch just anything, you go flying. And it's really, really annoying, honestly. Yeah, this is not the hardest staff boost I've left for sure. I have like Dragon Builder Grounds, Shroom Ridge, and Rainbow Road are for sure harder. RBC, or like N64 Bowser's Castle, might be harder, I don't know. I'll have to put that one in, I'll have to beat both of them and compare which one's harder. But yeah, those are definitely the five hardest. Those four and then this one are definitely in the top five for the hardest ones I've left. And then I just have like Volcanic Valley, which is obviously easy. Not that easy, just I haven't really done it yet for some reason. Same with GCN Bowser's Castle, I haven't done that one either. And Suzuka Circuit is definitely the sixth hardest one I have of the eight. And then Volcanic Valley is the seventh, and then GCN Bowser's Castle is the easiest one I have left. That's probably how it goes down. Suzuka Circuit is just annoying. It's honestly just annoying. I don't enjoy driving the track at all. I don't enjoy the track in general. Staff boost is by Sword of Seals. So it's not, you know, it's difficult. It's an auto track. And you know, for those of you who don't know, at least for me, auto with Nunchuck is just a pain. I'm bad with auto to start off with, and the fact that obviously since with classic controller and GameCube controller, you can really use in the D-pad. And so it's automatic. What you have to do, I'm pretty sure, is you have to drop your wheelie before you do any other turn, because it just makes it so you can turn much sharper. I don't even know. It's just faster, apparently. And you can just drop your wheelie by pressing the down button on your D-pad. But with Nunchuck, what you have to do is you have to, you know, swing your arm down. And it's a lot slower than tapping the D-pad. And sometimes your wheelie just doesn't even drop. So it's just super inconsistent. It's really annoying. Not a fan of it, so definitely gonna go manual on that one. People have told me to go Sneakster. That's probably the strat for Suzuka Circuit. I beat the other auto track, N64 Rainbow Road yesterday, and that was super intense. I've probably never sweat? I've never sweat more playing a track, honestly. I'll explain that later when I actually upload that video, but that was honestly a pain as well. I need to focus. I got like a really good run first try, and then I just haven't gotten any other runs yet. I mean, it's nothing. It's a hard track, so. And I was like not focusing at all on my driving. I was just kind of talking. I don't know if that's a slow trick, but it still works. I didn't get a trick off that, yikes. Using more time. Yeah, see, whoa, okay, we almost lived. Okay. Dude, okay, I need to stop hopping onto these things as I hopped onto it. It's like, I like in that decreased air, you know? Oh yeah. Alright, so I got, look how much time that saves, just broken. Okay, if I'm faster, I can get a trick off that as well. That. Unfortunately, we can't get tricks off those things. Which sucks, but whatever. Not gonna really, I'm just gonna fall off. Okay, I see that if that was lap two and I'm winning, I would have just, I would have RQ'd probably. That's why I need to make sure not to fall off there. Cause that's just a waste of an attempt. I can't be losing on places where, you know, it's just free. You can't lose there. Yeah, the bats are just freaking beast, man. What? I'm getting consumed by the mountain. Yo, what the heck is going on? Help? 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 Whoa! Dude! I'm stuck. Yo! What? I'm slowly dropping. Hold on. I just got consumed. The mountain ate me. Though I just got eaten by the wall. Dude, that camera angle though. I can just see like the lava. And we're dead. Okay. Where am I gonna respawn? Oh, here? Okay. Solid. This track's great. I love this track. Okay, that's scary. Once you get out of control, it's just like super hard to recover. I kind of did there, luckily though. Nice. Safe. That works. All right, there we go. No! I can't believe I failed that. Lap two, man, I never failed that shortcut. That could have been it right there. Like for sure, 100%. I don't know how fast he drives lap two, but he's on Dry Bowser. I don't have to do that shortcut again. Damn. Can't believe I failed lap two, man. I was way too tight. I had way too tight of an alignment and I just couldn't get it. Couldn't get inside the thing. I almost made it too after I tried the ultimate route. If I got a trick up the snow there, like when I fell down, I could have kept going, but that's sad. What the? Okay, I mean we're alive. Sketchy. Nice, nice, nice. Ah, wait, wait, where do we go here? Okay. No, there's a fireball there. I didn't know that. Well, lesson learned. Ah, you live to learn. Now I know I have to go more left and get a trick off that first one, not the second one though. Okay, we can get it, we can do it, we can do it. Wow. Ah, the wrong way. That was kind of slow. I need a good loop skip now. Nice. All right, it's doable. No. Wait. Are you kidding me, dude? It's the loop skip, man. It's the loop skip. We failed it, and we would have won anyways if we didn't mess up the other part. This is so free, dude. This is so free. I can't believe I lost that. I can't believe I lost that. Yeah. No way. No way. Horrible start. Yeah. Works. Don't fall, Lucas. No way. Please just win. No, I got a drop! Are you kidding? Are you kidding? Kidding. Stupid loop skip. This stupid loop is honestly so... I would have won either way. I still could have won. Are you actually kidding me? 40 milliseconds. I'm so fed up with this track right now. I should have beaten this an hour ago. I mean, not even an hour ago. I'm only like 2 hours into this. Should have been beaten by now. 100%. 150%. Like, I don't even know anymore. Oh my god, why did I even go for this loop skip, dude? 0.9! What the heck? No! Stupid bat. Stupid Batman! What the heck? I got 0.9 ahead without even doing the loop. Okay, I'm just not gonna do the loop anymore. It's clear, like... Oh no, he gets really, it's not good. So right now the bat shouldn't be a problem though. Right now it should be free real estate. For one. The finish line, please. GG's 253.7. Let's go. What a time. Yes. Yes, yes, yes. Thank the Lord I've figured out that the loop skip is only faster if you do it optimally. And what I was doing, I was slowing down so much that even if I just got the perfect stick, it's probably just the same as going around and doing the loop. So when I got that one lap, like 0.9 ahead when I did the loop normally, I'm like, okay, this is free. This is so free. All I have to do is just get one run where I make the turn skip shortcut and I'm good to go. Like completely good to go. Luckily, the problem was, again though, the bat slap too, if I'm really fast, are a huge problem. But this one, I had a pretty slow start to the lap too, and so the bats weren't as much of a problem, and I just got to easily just drive a lap. A little bit of nerves at the end, but I got it done, and I actually ended up winning by like quite a lot, 0.7. So yeah, this one's actually not the hardest staff goes, for sure. It only took me like 2.5 hours, which it should have taken me a lot less, because I failed two runs. Like one run like what, 0.2 behind, and the other one 40 milliseconds behind. But this one was a lot better, especially since I decided to not go for the loop skip. Really good. All right, so as you can see, I got my really good time of a 336.495. Probably with the Wii Wheel too. Like the staff goes is like, look at these times. These amazing times. The staff goes is like the easy ones, like a 2.301 or something. Then I got a 2.58, another really bad time. 2.54.6, this is pretty solid. 2.54.506, 2.54.466, 40 milliseconds, unless my math is horribly wrong. But 40 milliseconds off the staff goes because of a wheelie drop. I should have, honestly, if I just hopped onto the boost panel and gone the lower area to the wheelie once I landed, I would have won, but I just didn't do it. But doesn't matter because we got a 2.53.728. This is probably a really good time. I might even be able to go for like, I don't know about tops, but we'll see what this ranks up. And I might even be able to, I can definitely push it down where I made some mistakes in this one as well. Of course, this one's probably gonna stay forever because I don't know if Roosevelt is even playing this game anymore, and this time is just insane, but glad to beat this. 7 more left to go. Never thought, I thought this one would take hours and hours, but it really didn't, and I'm really glad for that. But we only have 7 more left, and we are getting closer and closer to 250 gold stars. That is all for this one. Thank you guys for watching this episode of Road to 250 Gold Stars, and I'll see you all next time.